Now let's go back to our editor and turn this into a mini shopping list application. Okay, we're gonna add a bunch of code here that I'll walk you through as I go. Okay, first thing I'm gonna do is replace this input type hidden line with a %s. And if you recall, %s is the Python string formatting character. Let me give you a quick example of that. I'm in Python real quick. If we have a string, you know, hello %s, and I say percent Steve, it substitutes the string following the percent sign into the %s in the string. So if I were to say greeting equals hello %s, and I can say greeting Udacity, it substitutes that string in. So anyway, just kind of basic Python. Just want to make sure you understand that because I'm going to abuse it in this lesson. Okay, so I replaced input with %s. I'm going to add a couple more templates here and then explain things as I go. Okay, and now I'm going to add a couple more strings, HTML strings, and I'll explain them as I go. What I'm trying to do here is make a big mess for you that we'll clean up using templates later. Okay, again, I'm using another triple quoted string so I can enter HTML. I'm going to make my input type equals hidden, name equals food again, and value equals %s, because I'm going to substitute more values in here. And I'm going to make one final string that will represent a shopping list. A couple blank lines, a little title, and then an unordered list. Remember, the UL tag makes an unordered list. I'm going to use %s to represent our content inside there. And then I'm going to close my unordered list tag. Now, you'll notice I'm not really indenting things, and we're not getting any nice syntax highlighting. That's because I'm editing strings in Python. It's not an ideal way to go, but it's what we're doing for now. Okay, now let's update our main page handler to do more than just print out the form HTML. Well, actually, let's take a look at what happens if I just print out this HTML as it is. Okay, we're back in our browser, and I've reloaded the page. And now you can see there's this big, ugly %s in the middle of our form. Remember, this is in the HTML. This is where our hidden element used to be. If I were to look at the source for this page, you can see it right here in the browser, that ugly %s. So anyway, let's go back to updating our code. First thing I'm going to do is build up a string called output. It's going to start off as our form HTML, and this is what we're going to return to the user. So I'll go ahead and update this to return output. Okay, and now remember our form HTML has a %s variable in it, so I'm going to make a holding place for the value I'm going to put in there, and I'm going to call that hidden HTML, and that will refer to, that'll hold the content that we're going to sub into there. That'll be where our hidden inputs go. Okay, now this line here gets all of the get parameters, or post parameters for that matter, called food. Get all basically means in App Engine, basically says if there are multiple parameters with the same name, get all of them and put them in a list. So items will be a list of all the food parameters that are in the URL. Okay, now we're going to loop over all of each of those items. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to add our hidden HTML line. Okay, and actually I have a little bug here. I'm going to rename hidden HTML to be output hidden. I'm going to prefix all of my strings that are holding output HTML with the word output. And because I originally called that hidden HTML, but we're already using that up here to refer to this little HTML string for hidden input. So for each item in items, add to the string hidden HTML substituting the food name. So basically, output hidden will be a bunch of input type hiddens where the value is the food from the URL. Okay, I'm going to add another string in here. We'll call it output items. And also for each item in items, we're going to append another little bit of HTML. And you can see, I didn't create item HTML. Let's add that real quick up here after our hidden HTML. And this will be a list item that goes inside the shopping list HTML. So we're going to add up a bunch of those. So we've got output hidden, which will be a bunch of hidden inputs, and output items will be a bunch of list elements. Okay, now we're going to use our shopping list HTML equals shopping list HTML, substituting in our items, and then our output. And then to the end of our output, we're going to add our shopping list. And we only want to add things to our shopping list if there were actually items in the response. So if the response is empty, none of this is going to work. So let's make sure we do this properly. So I indented everything. As you can tell, this is getting somewhat hard to read. That's kind of the point. And finally, we're going to take our overall output and substitute in the hidden string that we've been building up here. Now, when all of this is said and done, this is going to give us a basic shopping list functionality, which I'll demo now, and then we'll walk through the actual code.